We're going to talk about the wise things you could do to deal with inflammation. Now, inflammation is becoming quite a buzzword. Everyone's talking about it from anti-aging perspective to chronic disease. People are talking about inflammation and its connection to cancer, inflammation and its connection to heart attacks, inflammation and its connection to skin issues. And all of it is true, okay? So if you have generic inflammation going on in your body, it is going to make your health worse. What can you do to bring this inflammation down? There are quite a few things. Starting off with the simplest one, which is food. So if you eat clean, whole food, which is not ultra processed, which is not, your quick eats with a lot of additives and junk and preservatives, if you avoid that kind of processed food and you eat just whole food, it is going to bring down inflammation. Now in food also, I would recommend everyone who is experiencing, let's say, things like high CRP, high ESR, these are markers of inflammation. So if you have high homocysteine, high CSR, high ERP, if your WBC panel is kind of messed up, then I would also recommend, or if you have liver inflammation, if you have elevated liver enzymes, or if you're seeing that you feel like there's something going wrong in your body, when I say eat whole clean food, the other aspect about food is just avoid some of the things that can make inflammation worse. One of them is seed oils. So oils that come from, let's say, groundnut and your mustard, sarson ka tel, or sesame, or sunflower, all of these are seed oils. These are pro-inflammatory, so they can increase your inflammation in the body. So cut them out. What you can have instead is more of, let's say, coconut oil. You can use ghee for cooking, you can use butter for cooking. These are not inflammatory fats. The other thing that can trigger inflammation is dairy. So if you're sensitive to dairy and if you have it, it can trigger inflammation in the gut, which can then contribute to overall inflammation. Also, gluten is a known irritant, and I would, like, generally, even when we work with clients, we ask them to avoid gluten. Along with white sugar. What can you eat instead when it comes to food? Good clean animal protein. White rice is a great source of carbohydrates. Organic seasonal fruits and vegetables are again great. So these, in fact, all these colored fruits and vegetables and the berries do have antioxidants in them. These reduce inflammation in the body. Other than that, everyday sunlight exposure, especially sunrise and sunset, does have a anti-inflammatory effect on the body. Grounding, so being barefoot on earth, just spending time in nature, all of these things are known to bring down inflammation. Drinking good quality clean water, because a lot of the inflammation often is caused by dehydration. So drinking clean filtered water that has minerals added back into it is a great way to keep yourself hydrated. And other than that, I would recommend getting good quality sleep, because when you sleep well, especially if you sleep in absolute darkness, your body produces, in fact, even before you go to sleep, so when the sun starts setting, if you have good hygiene around light, so you're not exposing yourself too much to blue light, you're wearing blue light blockers, your body starts producing something called as melatonin, and melatonin is what also helps you sleep better. The more in darkness time you spend, the more melatonin is released by the body. Melatonin is anti-inflammatory. Some people, in fact, take melatonin supplements for its anti-inflammatory, antioxidant properties. So melatonin is known to bring down inflammation. So good quality deep sleep in absolute darkness is another great way to bring down inflammation. And cold exposure, okay? So ice baths, for example, or dunking hands up to wrists and face into ice cold water. Cold exposure again is a great way to bring down inflammation. So just some easy quick ways to reduce the inflammation going on in your body. But if you have a constantly elevated hsCRP or a constantly elevated ESR level, it could be indicating things like autoimmunity, and then my recommendation is to get a full blood work done, full panel checked, and then work with experts so that you can get to the root of whatever's causing your inflammation and resolve it from there. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.